In Jesus' precious name, we pray.
Amen.
So, Lord, we thank you for your presence, Lord, having examined us for this last week and this last month. You brought us into the new year, and you have, Father, kept us alive even till this new month, to which we are here, Lord, with joy and grace and thanksgiving, Lord, sincerely, with a heart full of appreciation, to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For you are a covenant-keeping God. In your faithfulness, we are here. In your faithfulness, we are here. In your goodness, we are here. It is not of any man's making. It is your doing. Receive all the praise and all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
As we search the scriptures, Lord, open our eyes and understanding. Thank you. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be seated. Be seated. Yes, we continue our study on the topic of the demand for Christian commitment. The demand for Christian commitment. And let's go to our passage where we are considering since last week, which is the book of Ephesians chapter 5, 21 through 33. Ephesians, it's important to show to have your Bible. If you don't have it as the print Bible, you should have it in your WhatsApp, in your phone or your iPad or any of the gadgets, you know, that should contain your Bible. Don't ever come to church without your Bible. We look at it on the demand of Christian commitment. Ephesians 5, 4 verse 20. To wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands. Husbands, love your wife, or your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify it and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Amen?
Amen.
Are you all there?
Yes,
Pastor. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever yet hates his own flesh, but nourisheth it and cherisheth it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, and of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, But I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you, in particular, so love his wife, even as himself. And the wife see that you reverence her husband. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. This study is a guide to Christian commitment. We are not talking about marriage per se, but we are using the analogy to express the need for commitment. Commitment is an obligation into a thing you have decided to undertake. Commitment is an obligation you have decided into anything you have decided to do. It's an obligation you have placed upon yourself. Commitment. Somebody say commitment.
Commitment.
Say it again.
Commitment.
Say it again.
Commitment.
Say it again.
Commitment.
Say it again.
Commitment.
Commitment. And I've made our Bible study an interactive session so that it wouldn't be that I am preaching. But I will interact and you can raise your hand and ask questions. We're using the marriage circle as an illustration to enable us to know what commitment is all about. We do know that people who are not serious believers do engage in boyfriend and girlfriend. And in reality, to have a boyfriend and a girlfriend, in the sense of the worldly attachment, is not condoned by the scriptures. And that we should put in our head and get to know that very well. If you say, I have a boyfriend, I say, girl, I have a girlfriend, well, you guys, both of you have decided to engage on what you want and how you want to live your life. Biblically, it's not accepted and allowed. If it's a casual friend out there, fine, maybe a schoolmate, maybe a coursemate, maybe a colleague in the office, maybe just a friend, but no strange or romantic sense attached, fine. Anything beyond that is not allowed in the scripture. So, the relationship between a boy and a girl at the courtship stage is not the same as when we are married. Hello, are we all together? Do I have your attention? Yeah. So when you're courting, it's courtship. When you're married, it's marriage. So there are demands at the courtship level, and there are demands at the marriage level. So we are looking at this passage and trying to dig out what is expected of a wife and what is expected as a husband. And from there, we will now know what's expected from us. Because the Bible talked about Christ and the church. That's why the illustration is very beautiful. The Bible talks about Christ and the church. So every one of us should begin to pick a lesson from this and endeavor to move beyond where you are into where you want to be with God this year. Move beyond where you were in 2019 to a different height of relationship. Move out from what you were doing last year. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
I always say that it's good that you come to church. That's wonderful. That means you have a desire to know God, but move beyond coming to church and enter into a personal relationship. Personal relationship is totally different from group relationship. Are we all there? In a school, you are all students. But when it comes to passing your exam, studying is no more, it's not a group thing, it's a personal thing. True or false? I mean, in a class, the teacher will teach you as a class, a group of students. But when it comes to learning and studying, you do it yourself. It's a personal thing. The teacher will not pass all of you. Okay, all of you have been here since 2012 or 13. Okay, you stayed in this class for how many years now? I pass all of you to the next level. No, you merit your next level. True or false? You labor to move to the next level. Some guys have been in the university or in the class for some years. Most of their classmates have passed out and they are still there. No, you need to move to your level by yourself. Struggle, discipline to move to the next level. So that's what we are talking about. Moving to the next level in relationship, from courtship to marriage. Hello, are you all there?
Yes,
so that's what we are looking at. Okay, let's enter our study and try to get out something this morning. Last week we began to see that wives must submit to their own husbands. We saw that submission. We talked about what? Submission. Hello, are you all here? We talked about what? Submission. That wives should do what? Submit to their own husbands. A wife should not submit herself to another man. Come on. Another woman's husband. If you do it, you are engaged in another relationship. So to your own. So we discover that when submission is impossible, it means there is something cracking in that relationship. When submission is not flowing, when a woman refuses to submit the obedience to the husband, something is wrong somewhere. Are we discussing?
Yes.
Hello, do I have your attention? Shout amen.
Yes.
So, that's what we are learning. That you should submit your own. So we learned that Christ should be my Lord and my Savior, my own husband. Then submission becomes very easy. If your husband loves as a wife, and your husband says, let this water, please always keep this water on top of the shelf or somewhere in the house, in the room, in the parlor, so that whenever I come, I will find it there to take it. And he comes the first day, it's not the second day, it's not the third day. Oh my dear, what's happening? I told you to keep this water here from your eyes. I'm sorry, I'm busy. Then you pass. Another day, I'm sorry, I'm busy. Another day, I'm very, very busy. What do you think your husband will say? Hello, hello, are we all here?
Yes,
what do you think your husband will think? It means you are not serious with his. Are you there?
Yes,
it shows you are not serious with his instructions. It means you're not serious to do what he wants. You're not there to please him. Submission becomes is when you want to please who you love. And that is why it says, wife, submit to your own husband. We need to really enter into this study to know who is a husband. That will help us to know who is a husband. Because the Bible says Christ is the head. The church is the bride of Christ. Hello, are we all together?
Yes.
If Christ is the head of the church, it means he is our husband. He is our who?
Husband.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
And we are his bride, or vis-a-vis his wife. So, who is a husband? That we have to look into deeply. Why must I submit to this person called husband? Talking about ladies. Why must I yield myself and submit? That is very important, because it is just there that some people will just pick a man and call him a husband. No, people marry for several reasons. True or false? Hello, are we together? Let me bring you into the discussion. Why do people marry? Give me some reasons why people get married, male and female. Why do people get married? Tell me. We are trying to see who is the husband, because it's very important. If we don't know who is the husband, then submission to a lady becomes difficult. And if you don't know yourself, your role, and who you are as a husband, why am I called a husband? What does that mean? My wife will say, husband, bad. Hello. Are you there? So, who is husband? And that's what we are trying to look into. Why do people marry? Tell me. Who was already married there? Who is married? Pastor. Apo is here. And our Pastor Simon, my brother, is here. Why do people get married? Tell me. Some of you don't know why you're married and why you want to marry. Okay, then it becomes a study. Ephraim, you want to get married then? Very soon, right? Because a lot of my young men are saying, I have received a lot of prayer requests that this year will not pass me, and I will shout to them from a distance. Because I want it to happen, because I know what it means. Why do you want to get married? And what are the reasons why people get married? Why do people get married? Tell me. Anybody?
Because they say I'm of age.
Yeah. Okay, people marry, yeah. My brother in glasses.
Also, people marry just
to get kids.
To get?
Kids.
Children. Kids. Okay. You see, that's... Who will be our secretary? I want someone to write it down. Why people get married. Number one, because they are of age. I need a good secretary. Who can do that for me? Anybody in the house? Just to write it out for us. We are coming to your reason. I just need one who will note it down for me. We cannot have somebody. All of you have type tests now. Nobody can just write for us. Okay. Madam, write it for us so that. Number one reason. Sir, I don't know your name. The pillar is not doing a good job. Madam, write it for us. Number one reason, because they are of age. Number two, because they want to have kids. Number three, yeah, you raise your hand, right? Yeah.
To have purpose.
To have?
Purpose. To fulfill your destiny, have purpose.
To have purpose. What is that purpose? That's what
purpose.
Focus.
Focus. Okay, to be focused in life. Okay, to be focused. Okay, number three, that's to be focused. Why do you want to get married? Because some of you say, I want to marry. Because you're fighting for a position. It's like, why do you want to be a governor? Why do you want to be the president? I'm in politics. I'm a politician. Why do you want to lead? You know, some of them don't know why they're there. Their eyes are in money. You know? Hello? Okay. Now tell me, someone was going to say, why do people get married? Yes, my young man.
Some get married for companionship.
Okay, some get married for the purpose of to have a companion. Yes, the lady is raising her hand. What's your name?
Precious. Precious, sir.
Oh, Precious. Okay.
I think people get married to build a home.
Okay, you see? A very good one. People get married so that they will build what? A home, start their own home. Okay. Yeah. Are we listening? I'm not seeing anything. Okay. Because I'm not seeing anything. Yeah, to have their own home. Okay. Yes, you were listening. Okay.
I think people get married. Bible says two is
better.
Two is better than one, I think.
Okay. Why do you want to get married? Because you're fine to get married, right?
Yes, sir.
Two are better than one. Okay. It aligns with that companionship view. You need to ask yourself what you want to be. Yes, my brother. Are you married?
To be responsible,
explain. Are you married or yet?
Married.
Yeah. You have five kids or ten? One.
Yeah.
Come. Congratulations. Why did you get married?
And like some place of work. If you are not married, then we kill as you are doing that.
You're irresponsible. So to become irresponsible now. Suppose there was no demand for that responsibility, do you get married? Okay, okay. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Are we all together here? Note it down. I want to see it highlighted, please. Do me a favor, remove the Bible passage. Yes. Children, if it's passing like CNN, nobody will understand what you are doing. Let me listen. Yes, my brother, you were raising your hand.
I think.
You're not sure.
Well, I think some people get married in order to have an assistant.
Have an assistant.
In the family.
Okay. Fine. Are you married?
No, that is.
Yet to. This year or 5 years to come? Or 10 years?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure when you want to get married. How old are you? This problem here. How old are you? 27. Look, I'll give you the next 3 years. Work hard. Okay, praise God. You want to raise your hand? Tell me why people get married.